Plus, a performance from R&B.
Well, it's been a couple of great busy months for our next guest. In addition to winning this season's Dancing with the Stars competition, he and his wife welcomed their first child. Mm. On top of that, this Friday, he's hosting the Miss USA pageant. Please welcome Drew Lachey. Boy, all of a sudden, it's all about Drew Lachey.
Yes, Drew Lachey.
Drew Lachey.
Now, look
things
at this.
Are good.
Look at this baby Lachey.
Yeah, boy, this was just born, I imagine, right, Isabella?
Yeah, she's about 10 days old there. I took that picture with my little knife on camera.
Oh, like a photographer, too.
I'm a hack, but yes, I do.
No, it's
I do
a beautiful picture.
Have a hobby.
And now the baby's home, and how are you guys holding up?
A lot of sleepless nights, but we're doing well, you know?
Good.
I'm sure you guys can relate.
Oh,
do
sure,
you get
absolutely.
Up? Do you take a feeding?
I am diaper daddy, you know?
Wow.
I'm all in there doing it and getting it done, so.
When you're getting it done, do you do a little dance around the you know, the...
Usually when things are shooting at me, yeah. You know, it's just like, gotta duck and weave, you know?
But where should we start with you? My gosh, so much going on in your life. Let's just review the Dancing with the Stars.
Okay.
Excuse me, but...
You all right?
What should I do?
Okay.
Ever since that lady gave you the shirt. Do they call you, or do your agent call them? How do they select these stars to begin?
They called me.
Out of the blue, they just called
out of the blue. They just called my manager one day and said we were wondering if Drew would be interested in doing the season of Dance with the Stars. And it took me a minute to say, yeah, just because I didn't want to get my chops busted by my friends, you know?
Were you much of a dancer?
No, I mean, I danced with 98 Degrees, and I mean, we danced right over there.
Sure.
You guys saw what we did.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's not dancing.
No, but you went to a performing arts high school, though, didn't you? So that had to help with some, I mean, isn't dancing a requirement or something?
It was, but, you know, it's a far cry from tap 101 to ballroom dancing in front of 27 million people. On
sure.
With a professional ballroom dancer.
So you thought about it, you finally said yes, and then how were you hooked up with your partner?
I told him it had to be someone short.
Okay, fine.
You know?
Fantastic.
Do you pick your partner, or do they pick her for you?
They picked her, then it was a great match. I mean, honestly, I couldn't have asked for a better partner. She was professional, she did a great job.
Cheryl Burke.
Do you still keep in contact?
Yeah, I talked to her yesterday.
No kidding.
Absolutely. We became very good friends.
And then how does everybody find the time to rehearse, because the rehearsals are exhaustive and long?
Yeah, we rehearse 4 hours a day, minimum.
Every day.
I didn't have a day off from December 26th until I won. So it was a good time commitment, but it was all worth it. I had a great time, and it's leading to other things. It's leading to the Miss USA thing.
Yeah.
Kind of opened a lot of doors in my career, and I'm just having a great time.
Your wife must be thrilled that you're an expert dancer now, right?
Well, she already was. She's a professional dancer, so it's...
Your wife is?
Yeah.
You specialize in those, don't you? You're doing all right, Drew Lachey.
Right.
You're doing all right. You're doing good. Well, when we come back, we'll talk about the Miss USA pageant. Here's your new host.
Tomorrow on Live.
Looking stronger every day. Drew Lachey is here. Remember 98 Degrees. So whatever happened to the whole group?
Everybody just kind of started doing their own thing.
Really?
The boy band well dried up, basically.
Yeah. But it was fun, wasn't it?
It was a great time.
I don't believe it's dried up, because I believe you could easily put maybe a reunion album, one hit song.
Yeah, you know, we're all like in Walkers. It's like the man band. You know, I'm about to turn 30 this year, so it's not really the boy band thing anymore.
It's over for the boy band.
I know. Over the hill. Forget about it.
Drew was co-host, you know, when we were looking for the next co-host, we had like five months, something there, and you were the guys, my co-host for that. It was a lot of fun.
It was a good time.
Yeah.
I remember jumping rope. We did like a fitness and exercise segment, and I remember tripping over the jump rope. That's what really stands out in my mind, so.
That's funny.
That's what he remembers. Okay.
No, but you appeared on Broadway in Rent last year.
Yep.
Do you have any big dreams of coming back to Broadway?
I would love to. I had a great time doing Rent. A lot of the cast members of that show are my good friends now.
True.
So if it was the right show, the right situation, I would love to come back and give it another run.
So now, they called you to host Miss USA, huh?
Yeah, it's kind of
that came
weird.
Out of the blue, too. Things are happening
to you.
You
know, good things happen to good people,
well,
I try to live a good, clean life.
Attaboy.
So it's live?
It's live. What's up with me and all the live TV?
It's nerve-wracking, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm a wreck. But anyway, we had the 51 ladies here yesterday. Very attractive bunch, Drew.
Well, I hope so. It's a beauty pageant, Regis.
Absolutely. And you gotta look very spiffy, you know?
Yeah, and I'm standing next to Nancy O'Dell, who's the other co-host. And,
yes.
And so, again, I'm standing next to a tall, blonde woman again.
She
it's like Stacey Keibler on one side and Nancy O'Dell on the other side.
Oh, that'll be fun.
She's about 6'6". It won't bother you.
6'4", I think, yeah.
No, we'll get you a half apple. You can stand on that.
Oh, I need a full apple. No, if the full... stand up.
So have you had meetings about the show this week?
Yeah, we've been doing press, and I met with the producer and talked to him about what they want from me, and I said, as long as you're not expecting much, we'll get along fine. Just expect me to stand out there and try and make
a joke
or two.
So they're not going to have talent for these girls, right? We discussed that
yesterday. They're not going to have talent for the hosts either, obviously. Right.
But how are they going to decide? Just strictly on looks?
It was a joke! Yeah, it basically
strictly
is.
Strictly on looks.
Yeah, it's looks, bathing suit, evening gown, and obviously you need to be well-spoken and be able to carry yourself very well.
I don't mind that. I think it's a beauty pageant.
It is.
Why
it's
shouldn't
a beauty
it be
pageant. It's the Super Bowl of beauty pageants, actually.
As the host, as I recall, I did a little hosting to Miss and
really?
Miss America years ago.
And you sang to Miss America.
Yes, I did. Yeah. But now, Drew, you're going to have to ask them those tough questions. Huh? What about global warming?
Global warming didn't exist.
Well, whatever it is, you know, whatever the questions are they come up with.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you could be a lip gloss, what kind of lip gloss would you be?
It's definitely going to be a challenge sometimes to keep a straight face, I'm sure. But, somehow I'm just going to have to pull it together, suck it up, and
remember,
go
right there in the front row, Mr. Trump is watching you.
Yes, me and Donald had a long conversation yesterday.
Did you?
Yeah, he told me if I screwed up, I'm fired.
Well, look, why don't we go out with a little dance?
Sure.
You know, Kelly's quite a dance. Wait a minute. Do you know the tango?
I know the tango. I know the cha-cha.
Is that in your repertoire? You learned them all. Shall we do a little tango, Gilman?
Cha-cha.
Cha-cha.
Do we have some music for Kelly and Drew?
I doubt we do. We never have music for us when we need it, but let's do it.
Let's find it. Here they are, Drew and Kelly.
Then you can change the handhold.
I like it.
You can do this.
I'm dancing with Drew Lachey in case anybody